The Grammys happened last night. A lot to talk about. Bruno Mars, in broad strokes, swept all the major categories. All the awards that were given out went to men, except for one, Alessia. I said it right. Alessia Cara won for Best New Artist. And there were a bunch of performances. We're going to get into all of it. But first, thoughts, five words or less.
Congratulations, Kendrick.
More Cardi, less Bruno.
Alessia, SZA, Camila, and Janelle, winners.
What a bunch of D's. What a bunch of dicks. And but what I mean is, people, I'm not, yeah, you know what I mean.
I know.
It was only men who got everything except
Sausage Fest galore.
Right.
All right, first, Bruno Mars swept the major categories. Song, record, album.
Yeah.
Jason, you're so happy for him.
I know. I felt last night that music's biggest night was ultimately music's biggest fail for me.
Yeah.
Because Bruno, there was this movement going on. First of all, of course, the Grammys are to celebrate accolades and accomplishments in music. I felt that CBS did us a disservice by how they presented it. You had so many missed moments because every break was like Grammy moments. And they also kept highlighting SZA, who we'll get to in a minute. But there was one poignant moment where a woman was talking about something that was really heartfelt and her audio was bad. I think it was Maren Morris that was terrible. And then you had Bruno Mars. The Time's Up movement was being honored by White Roses last night, okay? Mm-hmm. Not one winner acknowledged that in their speech. Not one.
Janelle Monáe made a speech about it.
She did.
But that was, you know, planned ahead of time, and she was chosen to make that speech. You're
right,
saying,
yeah,
like,
and
not.
And she was introducing Kesha's song, Praying, which talks directly about sexual assault. Right.
Before we get onto that, Bruno Mars, here's my problem with Bruno Mars.
What's your problem?
Bruno Mars, I tweeted last night, they came for Morris Day and the Nights. Bruno Mars came for Morris
Day and the Time.
Day and the Time. Otis Day and the Nights from Animal House. Sorry, I watched that on Netflix the other day. They came for Morris Day and the Time, and I didn't say anything because I wasn't into Morris Day and the Time. But last night they came for Bobby Brown, and there was no one to speak for me. Here's the problem with Bruno Mars. He doesn't write new songs. He takes every song from an era, mashes it up into what you kind of remember from it, and then just performs that. And he's not doing anything new. Right. I found out that he didn't pay Oops Upside Your Head ahead of Uptown Funk You Up. Uptown Funk You Up. Oops Upside Your Head.
Yeah.
Oops Upside Your Head.
Tell
he didn't
Brett.
Pay for that. He had to get sued before he gave it. Hmm. So up yours, Bruno Mars. No one's allowed to give you any more Grammys in the future. You're done.
Okay, so legal proceedings aside, taking that aside, because I think that's like that's definitely
title
concerning.
Line, Uptown Funk You Up is Oops Upside Your Head.
What about the expression where it says, you know, there's something like the best artists steal, or like good artists,
good artists
copy, great artists steal? Is there perhaps a nod to what he's doing?
Sure.
In that?
No. And he says it. He talks about because
talking about
Bruno Mars last
I'm
night.
I'm asking a question. I'm not Bruno Mars.
Grace, that's a great point. Bruno Mars, so Bobby Brown guy, that's New Jack Swing. That's a late 90s type of R&B and soul, right?
Which was the performance
exactly,
he did.
Which with Cardi B, Finesse, who, good for Cardi B, she looked great.
Yeah.
I'm with you. 24 karat magic or 24 karat gold or 24 karat something, there was better albums last year. There's better songs last year. I'm sorry. And Bruno, and what really like just did my head in was Bruno's when he was kind of drunk accepting his speech and his just this whole lack of the tone of the room, dude. I felt like if you're getting Grammy's biggest honor, you need to be aware of movements that are moving within the industry. The Grammys are the music industry's snapshot, myopic view of how they want you to view music and how they want you to purchase music now. So for Bruno to win last night and not even just acknowledge Time's Up or Me Too, not that he has to, but I feel like he should have, and you guys may disagree, that's cool, was really just nail in the coffin for me because I didn't like him before. And musically, he's great.
Listen,
but
Uptown Funk is such a good song.
Is it a good song?
It is. It's undeniable. Like whenever I'm like on a dance floor, which happens all the time, guys.
Obviously.
It just works. At my house, it'll come on and we'll start a dance party in the house. But I don't want to give you the Grammy for 24 karat magic in a year when like Song of the Year is Despacito. It broke every record. So if I but the Grammy, it's just so hard now, I think, to define what they mean by Song of the Year. And everyone has that joke, Record of the Year, Album of the Year, what does that mean? What's the difference? One's like production, the other is like songwriting. Mm-hmm. Whatever it is, it's just so hard to define. But when I hear Song of the Year, I think it's okay to like, Song of the Year goes to Despacito. Like, the production is difficult on the Bruno Mars song. He does do that better than a lot, if not everyone else. But then like, there's the third one, whatever one I haven't accounted for yet, that should go to someone who is doing something artistically awesome that defines the year.
Right, and sure, oh, go ahead, Darren, how you feel?
Oh, no, I'm the same with you. Ever since he has been on the scene, I've been like, okay, he's decent, but I don't see what all these like teens, like early 20s kids are seeing in this guy. And when I think about, you know, his album compared to my favorite one in that category, Damn.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Kendrick Lamar, just like what the tones of those albums are and what they're talking about is God. So
and being on the
couldn't
pulse
be
of, like,
so different.
The pulse
couldn't
of like so the moment that
yeah,
we're
exactly.
In.
And one is just for me, just what it's talking about is so important
exactly.
and relevant and needs to be said. And yes, we need feel good music, but I think that in this time, I think it's important to highlight those artists that do put out music that does change.
It's sort of like what Janelle Monáe was saying before she introduced Kesha, where she said, we come in peace, but we mean business. And I feel like that's why I said in my five words less, congratulations, Kendrick. I thought his performance to open the show
was incredible.
Incredible, was amazing, bringing Dave Chappelle on. I did not
think that. That was
CBS
crazy.
Got their money's worth out of Chappelle last night.
Yeah, they did.
They were like, we're going to work the hell out of you, Chappelle.
For winning for best rap album.
Yep.
But I agree with you, Darren. I think that probably would have been my album of the year.
For sure, for me, that hands down.
It's close to that, and Awaken My Love would be the two that I would think would compete for album of the year, but I don't think that. While I think that Bruno Mars put out an awesome, I do really like this album. I think it's really fun, and there is something to be said that his songs come on and they do bring a room together.
Yeah. And that's great.
But I don't think that like longevity wise, it's the album that we will be talking about.
Hold on one second. Yeah. That's right. So and then another moment that didn't happen last night was how do you have Ed Sheeran win solo pop when four of the nominees were female, and then Shape and what's the name of the song?
Shape of You.
Over SZA, over...
And like what the songs we're talking about that the women were putting out is just literally the opposite of Ed Sheeran's song he's talking about.
And he wasn't even there to accept the award.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm sorry, I will talk about what was right and positive about the Grammys, Patti LuPone. I just think last night was just not... They take no risks with the Grammys anymore. Yeah.
In relation to the idea that, you know, in the Ed Sheeran category, he was the only guy, he won. Only Alessia Cara, she was the only female to win one of the awards that they literally gave out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The response from Recording Academy President Neil Portnoy was this. I think it has to begin with women who have the creativity to step up because I think they would be welcome. I don't have personal experience with the kinds of brick walls that women face, but I think it's really a combination of us in the industry making a welcome mat very obvious, creating mentorships, creating opportunities, not only for women, but for all people, and moving forward, creating that next generation of artists who feel that they can do anything and say anything. It's a weird thing because at the beginning it's like, step up, ladies. But then he does come around and say, we need to make the welcome mat very clear.
Did you guys think that the attempt to be vocal and really shine a light on what we're talking about today, like the Me Too movement, immigration, like you had Sting, who Englishman in New York, was supposed to be a nod to, an anti-Trump nod to immigration. And then you had you too, get out of your own way. Did you guys think that those resonated with you or with the viewers? Because I felt they were trying to do stuff that just didn't happen last night. Janelle Monáe, to me, the two most standout things last night, besides Childish Gambino, was Patti LuPone, because she's just a legend. And I felt Janelle Monáe and Kesha. Those two things were like the most powerful last night that hit the mark, that landed, if you will, if you're trying to send a message.
Patti LuPone, there's a thing on Twitter where everyone thought that he said Patti LaBelle. And everyone was like, woo! What? Who? Wow, she's white. And then, LuPone, who is,
Broadway royalty.
And did Don't Cry For Me, Argentina. Mm-hmm. That was fine. It was a great performance, but she was just standing there. In a night when it's like the Kendrick one to open the show, I was just like, oh my God. God, this is everything.
I also had a suspicion of mine confirmed, which is that DJ Khaled is the worst part of every DJ Khaled song. And
what?
he has a skill in bringing producers and artists together on an album, for sure. And like this, the Wild Thoughts by Rihanna is great. But like the fact that he just kept like hyping her, you don't have to hype up Rihanna, she's Rihanna.
It's Rihanna.
But every time we hear your voice, like outside of just the introduction, makes the song so much worse.
So,
like
yeah.
I don't like you're watching Rihanna like dance all sexy just like this.
I've waited my whole life to be here.
And then you hear like, let's go. I'm like, no, we're going enough. It's Rihanna.
DJ Khaled.
But sure, her performance was great. I just realized that like he, like you get the intro, I get it, that's his thing, but like he is the worst part of the song.
You know who won
no
last
one
night,
loves
though?
That, his talking.
Who won?
The real person who won last night was SZA.
SZA.
Because her name is SZA, one.
Mm-hmm.
Two, the Gap commercial played over and over, which was really, really good. She was doing like the electric slide, it was hot. And because now SZA may have not won any of the five categories she was nominated in, but she is on everyone's lips.
Radar.
And she's the new neo soul. And
love
I think
her voice.
That, yeah,
her
we need SZA.
Yeah.
We
yeah.
need SZA.
And so we have to wrap, but Childish Gambino, really quick.
Oh my gosh.
I was gonna say before the show, you see a lot of influences go into Bruno Mars and come out, and they make me feel very mad at him. Gambino, when he takes a bunch of different musical influences, I'm not. I'm like, whoa, what a delightful musical landscape.
Mm-hmm.
It was a falsetto war,
mm-hmm.
which I think he beat the new Lion King voice at. But he's too cool now. He was from Derek Comedy, a bunch of nerds doing sketches. And now he's cool, and I feel left behind.
I don't think he's gonna. he'll always be the kid under the stairs, nerdy kind of kid. You know,
I hope, man, because he was so cool.
He was like so cool.
Mustache, and I was like, I'm not mad at it.
It's like his energy, Darren. He knew how cool he again. He was like Prince, Miguel, Maxwell. He walked out there and
he doesn't try. He
does. It's like I am a gift to humanity. Watch me work.
The intro was like, I'm gonna list all this. I forget who did it. They're like, I'm gonna list all this stuff, and you would hate that he's good at, and you would hate him if he wasn't so damn charming. And that's exactly. Yep. It was a perfect intro.
Brett, one more fail. Sorry.
Okay.
How do you put Gaga after Kendrick?
Oh yeah, that was rough.
Yeah, she also had stage makeup on, and they were like right up in her junk, and it was
a lot.
I'm sorry, Gaga. I'm sorry.
And then the lighting's never good. Poor girl.
CBS, do better.